In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of Apple Maps in your Flutter application. So, in our previous tutorials, we have seen the implementation of Google Maps in Flutter application. Those will be used in Android devices. And for iOS, we need to implement Apple Maps. So now, let's get started with the tutorial. So the first thing is, like, I have added the Apple Maps dependency over here, and this is the latest version available. So just try to update it to the latest version so as to avoid any conflicts in the code level. So now let's get started with the importing material.dart here. And if you are aware with all this basic coding, then you can just directly skip into the tutorial. So now let us try to specify run app over here, and within which we'll try to specify my app. And now let us try to declare a stateful widget which we will be naming as my app here. So the very first thing, we will be declaring an Apple Map controller here. So you need to import this particular package here. We have added the dependency, right? So based on which you can import this particular dependency and you can make use of Apple Map controller here. And now let us try to focus on initializing Apple Map controller here. So for which I'm going to create a method like onMap created, and here we are going to have Apple Map controller, and for which I'm going to specify a controller here like an object. And now let us try to initialize Apple Map controller to a controller here. And there we go, our controller is now initialized. And instead of returning a container, let us try to return a material app, and inside which let us try to specify scaffold. And you already well aware like why we make use of scaffold here. So let us try to specify an app bar quickly, and with the help of text widget we are going to specify here like Apple Maps. So yeah, and again we need to make it like a constant. So the next thing is, like, we are going to specify body here, and inside the body I'm going to specify a container, and here inside the container now I'm going to specify the Apple Map here. So here you are able to see the Apple Map, right? So just try to select Apple Map here. And here you got like initial camera position. So it's very clear to understand what's the initial camera position when you load the map for the first time, on which particular location you want the map to be loaded. So for example, you want your map to be loaded in New York City, and you can just specify the longitude and latitude values of New York City. So now we'll be specifying this in the way like camera position. So here, and target we are going to specify here. So within the target you need to specify lat long here. So I'm going to specify 0.0 initially, and once the map is loaded then we can just adjust them accordingly. So let's place this in the new line 0.0. okay, and yeah, we can make this constant for now. And so now let's try to run our code in the iOS simulator. So here we go. We have got the Apple Maps loaded on our simulator. And now let us try to locate a specific location and try to see how the Apple Map works. And also we'll try to make use of few features in Apple Maps. So let us try to see how they work on Apple Map. So I'm just searching like lat long here. And here you can find a website where you can find the values when you try to search for a place. So here I'm going to search like Statue of Liberty, and let's tap on find here. And here we go, we have got the latitude and longitude values now. And now let's try to replace them over here. So now let's try to run this code again. Just try to save the code, and now let's try to rerun the code here. And here we go. Initially we were being located on Africa here, and now it is locating on North America. And the reason why is like we need to do few more things such that we exactly reach to that particular location. So here, what are the other options we are having here on camera position is like we can specify latitude and longitude, which we have just specified, and also heading, pitch and zoom. So for example, let us try to specify zoom here, and I'm going to specify it to be 50 and try to rerun the code. And now here you can clearly see Statue of Liberty. Now previously we were not able to see the Statue of Liberty. Instead, it was just showing the overall North America. And now once we specified the zoom here, we are able to see the Statue of Liberty. So just try to reduce the zoom a bit. So I'm going to make it like 30 and try to rerun the code. So okay, and now let's try to see two other parameters which we are having. And yeah, the two other parameters which we are having is like heading and pitch. So now let's try to specify what is heading. Okay, let's try to specify heading here, and I'm going to specify it to be 10. And let us try to observe the difference. So here a bearing of 90 means the camera pointing east. So here, whenever you are having any doubts, you can just go through the documentation by just tapping on the command, and you can just click on this heading over here. And if you are using Windows, then you can just tap on Control and tap on heading over here. So now let's try to specify 90 and try to observe the change. Okay, so we are moving in the east direction as they have specified according to the documentation. Okay, this works fine. And the next thing is like pitch. So let's try to specify pitch to be 40 here. And now let's try to save the code. Okay, so what exactly does pitch do? In degrees where 0 is looking straight down, pitch may be clamped to an appropriate value. And also we do have an options like zoom in and zoom out as well. So here we are inside a container. And actually we are not making use of any container here. So it is saying like remove unnecessary container, because you can just directly specify Apple map as a widget directly over here. So I'm just going to wrap it with a column, and I'm going to remove the unnecessary container here. And also, yeah, it is asking us to add a constant modifier. So instead of adding a constant modifier here, I'm going to specify a row over here, and within the row I'm going to specify children. And here let us try to have a text button. So I'm just going to show you a zoom in and zoom out functionality here. So I'm going to quickly just specify here text, and inside which zoom in. And if you are using Android Studio, you can just tap on Command D or Control D so that the entire line will be copied and added below. So zoom in and zoom out. And now let's make use of the controller. Okay, the Apple map controller we are having. Move camera. So everything you do is with the help of the move camera option over here. So initially when you are opening the map, also you have made use of the camera position here. And now also with the help of move camera, you are going to specify this. And now let us try to specify here camera update dot, and now you can just make zoom in here, zoom out, and all these functionalities here. So let's quickly copy this and add it over here and make it zoom out. And now you need to wrap the Apple map widget inside expanded widget here. So now let's try to wrap it, and yeah, we can just move this constant over here. And now let's try to run this code and see the output once. So here you can see like zoom in and zoom out buttons, but they are not in the center. Main axis alignment, and you can just specify main axis alignment to center. In order to make use of Apple Map controller here, we need to initialize it first. Though we have specified onMap created, but we need to call it. So now we do have a parameter like onMap created here, and let's try to sync with our method which we have declared. So now we have specified onMap created over here, and let's remove the constant. So you can just add constant over here if required. And now let's try to rerun this particular code and see the output once. And now here our map is now loaded, and also you can see our two buttons, zoom in and zoom out, is also available. And now let's tap on zoom out button, and here we can see we have zoomed out of the view. And now let's tap on zoom in button. So this way our zoom in and zoom out button works. And also there are few more functionalities which you can just try, and let me know if you are facing any issues, then I will surely try to help you. And also you can just specify new camera position also here. So again, how we have specified camera position here, the same way you can specify the camera position here as well, so that you can relocate to the new position on Apple Map. So whenever you are trying to create an application like Ola or Uber, where the device will move from one area to another, then you can just try to make use of new camera position and try to change the location on the maps. So this is it for this particular tutorial. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.